Here they are, the music scores for our record Aulin, Moberg, Andrée, Orchestral Works, as recorded by the Gothenburg Symphony Orchestra. For the first time since they were written over 100 years ago, they are now available for everyone to play and for everyone to listen. What you see here is the result of an incredible journey and a lot of hard work to bring these three women, these three composers, back into the light. The idea started in the summer of 2020, in the middle of the pandemic. Concert after concert was being cancelled, and we suddenly had time to do something really unique and lasting. The GSO has a long-standing tradition on working with the Nordic sound and with Nordic composers. And Aulin, Andrée being Swedish composers and Moberg being from Finland, it was the perfect choice for this recording. That's how we decided to record Andrée's first symphony, never been recorded before and never played since its premiere. Valborg Aulins Tableau Parisien, probably never performed before. And Ida Mobergs Orchestral Suite Sunrise. To say that it was a challenge to record these pieces is quite an understatement. Usually the Gothenburg Symphony records all of its recording in our fantastic concert hall, which is prize winning for its superb acoustics. This particular summer we had two problems. One, the hall was being renovated, and two, there was a pandemic, so the orchestra had to keep a big distance between each musician, so our stage wouldn't even have been large enough. So we had to rent the biggest space we could find in Gothenburg that was still acoustically suitable, and we ended up at Clarion Post Hotel in their largest conference room. With us we had a fantastic sound producer, Lasse from the company Nilento, and he created a studio atmosphere in this room.
Det är massa utmaningar, men svårast är ju alla ljud och allting utifrån när man har en ny lokal. Man vet ju aldrig hur det fungerar just med ljud, fläktljud och allt det där. Men vi var här och rekade innan och tyckte att det var tyst och bra. Så nästa utmaning är att få det att höra som konsert. Så det känns inte så för dem, för det är mycket torr akustik. Men för mig är det ju att efterbearbeta och göra så att det kommer bli liksom som Göteborgsfolkans sound då. Och det är väl utmaningen, men jag känns väldigt bra. Det är en jämn och fin lokal, och nu med det här coronaavståndet så är det klart att det är svinsvårt för alla musiker och allting.
We took a huge risk because no living person knew how these pieces sounded. Of course, I knew that these composers were really great because some of their other pieces are heard on concert venues today, so we had good hopes. But you know, until the scores were ready, until the music was standing on the musicians' music stands and we started rehearsing, nobody really knew how this music sounded. Our conductor Johannes Gustafsson had of course been studying the music for a long time, so he had a clear idea of how he wanted it to sound.
Jättestort ansvar är det ju, för att man kan ju inte liksom trycka på sin egen uppfattning, utan man måste ju försöka förstå vad musikaliska intentionen är. Och även om man studerar musik och studerar olika tonsättare kan deras musik så är det ändå liksom klingande intuition som gäller. Det är alltid när man har ohörd musik, oavsett om den är ny eller gammal, så är det ju en helt annan approach. Man har inget referensmaterial, varken liksom visuellt eller auditivt att lyssna på. Så att det är ju, man får söka lite grann. Så att det är ju lite svårt att veta också. Man får försöka ta lite val utifrån liksom intuitivt vad som funkar bäst. Och ofta får man också gå tillbaka till liksom ursprungsidén. Brukar ofta vara ett enkelt. Om det är något som har varit bearbetat som inte är färdigt, så är det nästan mer genomtänkt att använda den första tanken, även om tonsättaren själv har varit och tyckt annorlunda.
Så ska vara samma ton som det är på packstäcket, det här bara F, E, men
tack. So we had to start from the very beginning, which is the hands of the composers. And there is no better place for Swedish composers than the Music and Theatre Library in Stockholm, which holds the national collection of the Swedish music heritage. None of these three pieces had ever been edited and published, so the original manuscripts were our only source. If you're looking for treasures, that's where you go. Among those treasures at the library, there was a manuscript by Valborg Aulin for her Tableau Parisien, and a huge collection of Elfrida Andrées life and works, and among it, three fantastic sketches of her first symphony. So here we have it, finally. We can see Elfrida Andrées handwritten manuscript of her first symphony in C major. And we have the original sketch. And also we have another sketch here, which predates this one. And then finally, this is the material that the orchestra would have played. Elfrida is 27 years old, and the premiere was in Stockholm, and as you can see by what she has written here, förfärlig upplevelse. It was an awful experience for her. She later wrote that she thought the orchestra was playing wrong on purpose. And she was actually ill for a few weeks afterwards. And when she came back to her senses, that's when she wrote her big manifesto. And her life would from then on be to elevate all womankind. So this is the origin. This bad experience that she had was actually the origin of her manifesto, which we can harvest from today.
Jag får väldigt många beställningar på manuskriptet på verk av Elfrida André, och det är inte bara på symfonier utan körverk, sånger, allt möjligt. Alltså de senaste åren, jag kan säga att Elfrida var mest efterfrågad av alla svenska tonsättare. Jag kanske överdriver lite, men tror inte det faktiskt. Och det var till USA flera gånger, Nya Zeeland, alltså vilka länder som helst, och Europa också. Och så jag tror att vi kom till den punkten då inte bara musikforskare som beforskar kvinnliga och lyfter de kvinnliga tonsättarna, utan det är musiker som började sig intressera. Så den Elfrida spelas, det kan jag bara påstå, över hela världen. Och det är glädjande.
It's been in the archives for so long. It was heard once in 1868, and now we can hear it. We have recorded this, so now everyone can hear this. It was a risk, it was a challenge, but it was a collaborative effort where we had the research, we had the knowledge, and most of all we had the fantastic musicians of the Gothenburg Symphony, who always, when they see new music, even if it's old or new in time, they always look at it with the enthusiastic and fresh eyes and bring their best of musicality to express this music. With this record, I think we did more than just bringing these three pieces to the audience. We are writing these women back into music history again. You often say that women composers were forgotten, but to forget is such a passive word. They were actually actively edited out of music history. You can see that by looking at different editions of music encyclopedias. Now they are available for everyone to play, and this recording also means that programmers in concert houses can have a listen and find a place for these pieces in their repertoire. I'm so proud, and I hope that we have made Elfrida and Valborg and Ida proud as well. I think that they are thrilled.